The Callisto Protocol is a sci-fi survival horror game made by Striking Distance Studios, and it's considered by many a spiritual successor to the original 2008 Dead Space. Technically, the game is built using one of the latest versions of Unreal Engine 4, and as a result, it looks great and really next-gen, but the game has a lot of technical issues. First, at launch, the game suffers from the infamous shader compilation stutters. But the developer released a patch that partially fixed this problem and make the game pre-compile some shaders while at the main menu. Also, the game is very CPU limited and very single thread limited, especially when using RT as you can see here. And last and the most annoying problem is that you cannot change any of the graphical settings while in the game. You can only change resolution, gamma, brightness, and that's it. This is a real bummer, especially to me and anyone who loves to tweak the visuals. I don't remember the last game that did this, but this problem makes making this video a nightmare. And I hesitated at first, but at the end I've managed to do it. So without any further ado, let's get going. Now, because tweaking settings in real time in this game is impossible, I won't do all options in this video as I usually do. I'll only focus on graphical settings that drastically impact the visuals and or the performance. Kicking off with lighting quality, which is one of the most demanding settings in the game. Going from low to standard make most dynamic lights in the game capable of casting shadows, as you can see here. And because of that, it can make some objects and shadows look more grounded, like here. Performance-wise, light and quality have a big impact. Going from low to standard will drop FPS by around 20-25% in areas with a lot of lights. Now, these settings really helps with the overall presentation, but 20-25% is really a huge loss to performance, so I will recommend low. But if your GPU is capable and you have enough performance to spare, use standard. Next we have shadow quality. This one doesn't change the quality of all shadows as you can see here. It only affects dynamic shadows from lights, like here. Performance wise, going from low to medium drop FPS by 5% and to high 16%. Here medium is the best option. Volumetric quality adjusts the resolution of volumetric effects, like here where low looks flickery compared to medium or high. Performance wise, this one is demanding when using high, because going from low to medium drop FPS by 6%, but to high a massive 20%. Similar to shadows, using high is not worth it here, and medium is the best balance between performance and good visuals. Now moving on to particle quality, this one mainly adjusts the density of particles as you can see here between low and high. Performance wise, going from low to medium costs around 2% and to high 10%. Here medium looks similar to high but performs closer to low, that's why I recommend medium. Screen space reflection comes with two options, on or off. Enabling SSR will cost you almost nothing, so I recommend keeping this one on. Now let's talk about ray tracing. As I've mentioned earlier, the game is single thread limited and using RT just make it worse. Like here I have RT on, and if you take a look at my frame time graph, you can see that it's a mess. And playing like that is not great, even if the average FPS is close to 60. But anyway, let's do a comparison for RT shadows and reflections. Now RT shadows in this game improve the quality of rasterized shadows, like here. Or they can add subtle shadows like here. Performance wise, turning on RT shadows costs around 30% on the RTX 3060 Ti. RT reflections are more obvious than shadows, like here with this mirror, where SSR does not have any screen space data to show the reflection. Unlike RT, where at medium the reflections are low res compared to high. Going from SSR to medium RT reflections drop FPS by 21% and to high a big 38% on the RTX 3060 Ti. Now in general, I don't recommend using RT even if you have a powerful PC. you'll still see some drops below 60fps because the game doesn't utilize the CPU threads properly. Let's move on to depth of field. If you like this effect, you should know that using it will cost you around 11%. Next we have subsurface scattering. This effect simulates how light penetrates or passes through the skin, as you can see here between on and off, and it doesn't affect the performance, so I recommend keeping it on. And the last setting we'll take a look at in this video is texture quality. Here you can see that at 1440p without RT high, textures use around 5.2 GB. And as I always say, this one depends on your GPU VRAM and settings, especially RT. But with 8GB GPU, you should be fine at 1440p. Now based on what we've seen so far, these are my recommended settings. Let's do a comparison between Ultra and Optimized settings without RT. As you can see here, using Optimized settings should boost your FPS by 80% with minimal impact to the visuals. Now I want to talk about a problem with FSR in this game. As you can see here, FSR is disabled. Now if I load the game, I hit continue, you can see I get 55 to 55 FPS. Now if I return to the main menu to enable FSR like this with balanced mode, and I hit apply, and then I hit continue, you see that I get the same FPS, no boost, nothing. Also the image quality is similar. Now if this happens to you, what you need to do is you need to hit exit to the main menu and restart the entire game. Now if I exit and then I hit play again to relaunch the game, and then I hit continue, you can see here now that I get more FPS. I get 69, 50, or 70 FPS from 55. And that means FSR now is enabled. So this is what you should do if FSR doesn't work for you. Let's wrap this up. Overall, the Callisto protocol delivers gorgeous visuals for an Unreal Engine 4 game, but the technical issues really ruins the experience. From the bad CPU performance, which made using RT nearly impossible, to not allowing users to tweak settings while in the game. And speaking of tweaking settings, aside from ray tracing, lighting, volumetric and shadow quality are the most demanding settings in the game. And we arrive at the end. Thank you so much for watching and for your time. If you enjoyed the video, leave a like, and if not, leave a dislike. Don't forget to subscribe and hit the notification bell for any future videos, and hopefully I'll see you in the next one.